automation. First of all, we should know what is automation. Automation is a technology in which the mechanical, electronic, computer-based system are used to operate and control the production. In this, manual efforts are replaced by mechanical, electrical machines and computer. It is the self-acting capability of any device. Now, automation includes automatic material handling (MH) and storage system, automatic machine tool to process parts, automated transfer and assembly line, industrial robots, automatic feedback for process control, automatic inspection system for quality control, computer for planning, designing, data collection and support decision making processes. Now, the next one is manufacturing system. A manufacturing system is a collection or arrangement of operation and process used to make desired product or components. It includes the equipment and arrangement of process. Whereas, a production system includes all the aspects such as people, money, equipment, material supplies, sales, management, and even the manufacturing system itself. Now, we will discuss the classification of production activities. The manufacturing companies could be either of the three types: basic producers, converters, fabricators. We will discuss all the three one by one in upcoming modules. First of all, it is basic producers. They take the natural resources from nature and transform them into raw material to be used by another industry, as for example, steel producers. In this image, we can clearly see they are using natural resource and producing steels. The next one is converters. Converters take the output of basic producers and transform them into intermediate products or some consumer's item. As for example, paper mill converts wood pulp into paper. An important feature of converters' products is that it has very much simplified physical form. In this image, we can see it is the basic converters product of plastic. The next one is fabricators. They transform and assemble the final product. As for example, the plastic made by converter from petroleum product is finally transformed and assembled into auto body parts and so on. It could also be used in this plastic bottling. Now, the classification of production activities. We can classify production activities into three broad categories. They are job production, batch production or mass production. First of all, job production. Job production is the low volume or of say small size. This is usually made of meeting a specific customer order. Here, mostly wide variety of jobs come and hence production equipment must be very flexible and general purpose. An aircraft is an example of such jobs. In this animation, we can clearly see they are working on a particular job. Such job production is called a single job production. Now the next one is batch production. Batch production is for medium sized lots of some same items produced at some regular interval of time. Here also equipment used in general purpose but for higher production. Foundries, textbook publishing, plastic molding industry come under this category. In this category, CNC machines are broadly used because they use the theory of mid-volume, mid-variety. Now, the next one is mass production. It is continuous flow type, a specialized manufacture of identical product. Equipment is rather special purpose and a special tooling is used. Automobile, light bulbs, beverage, soft drink, bolt and nut manufacturing industry come under these categories. In this animation, we can easily see the virtue of mass production. Now, we will see types of automation. Automation is broadly divided into three types. The first one is hard, fixed, manual or skill-based automation. The next one is programmable automation, and the third is flexible automation. We will see all of the three one by one in upcoming slides. Now, first of all, it is hard, fixed, manual or skill-based automation. This type of automation is hardwired or fixed in such a way that the sequence of operation or processing or assembly is fixed by the configuration of equipment itself. The operations are simplified by the use of lever, screw, pulleys, etc. It can also be done by coordination of many complex operations into one machine or at one place. Characteristics of skill-based automation are: it is justified where production rate or volume are high, where high initial cost due to tailor-made equipment. It normally cannot accommodate product change. It depends largely on skill of designer. Machined assembly line, machining transfer line are example of hard automation. Now, the next one is programmable automation. In this type of automation production machine, assembly lines are designed with capability to change the sequence of operation to cater different type of product changes. This sequence is changed by the set of instructions called program of new product. Characteristics of programmable automations are: it is costly but generally purpose machinery. It is of low to mid production rate or volume. Little flexibility to suit change in product specification. It is suitable for batch production. Numerically controlled NC machines and industrial robots are example of programmable automation. In this animation, we can easily see that we give command in the form of programs to the machine tool and it works accordingly. Now, the next one is flexible automation. It is the latest type of automation, which is an extension of programmable automation. In this, no time is lost for the changeover from one product to next one. Virtual setup is reduced to zero level. Characteristics of flexible automation are: zero time for changing product change design. It is suitable for continuous production of variety of products. It is highly initial cost for tailor-made CNC. It has highly flexible for product changes. Its examples are use of pallet fixture for holding part for quick changeover, pallet or honey box type tool changer in CNC, FMX flexible, manufacturing system and machining center. We come to the topic need for automation. Why we needed automation? To know this, we need to focus our mind on ongoing trends in global industry where high productive requirements. We need to reduce lead time. The better quality of production were needed. The raw materials were getting costly. We need safety in operation. The labor shortage was also concerned. Higher labor cost was also an important factor. Shifting of manpower to service sector reduced working in process, competitive production for all lead to need for automation. Now, we will see the advantages of automation. First of all, it reduces lead time. Also, its setup time is eliminated. Better products with lower price is gained. In this, safer working conditions are obtained and lesser working hour is also achieved. Employment opportunity is given. It increased standard of living. Now, as we know that, along with advantages, all things come with few disadvantages. Now, we will see the disadvantages of automation. Its disadvantages are: system changes are difficult and slow to implement, high cost and long-term payback, lower skill labor of worker, retrenchment or unemployment is concerned, reduced purchasing power. Now, here I have drawn levels of automation. These are the following levels of automation that human attributes replaced and its example. Now, emerging trends in automation. The automated equipments can be used to produce discrete part in large volume. Their application may be vary from automated flow line, from material handling to robot and process control technology. A few categories of emerging trend in automations are as follow: the automated flow lines, automated machining process, automated assembly system. We will see the three one by one in next slides. First of all, it is automated flow lines. Automated flow line consists of several machine link through automated transfer device that carry raw work part at one end, and as the process are done on it, parts are moved from one workstation to another workstation, and the final product is obtained from the last point of the line. These lines can be of two types, inline or rotary. Inline, this type of arrangement follow a straight line movement and form the most at a turn of 90 degree due to factory layout limitation. And the rotary, its work part are kept on rotating table at fixed location. This type of equipment is known as a dial index machine. Now, automated flow lines. The automated flow lines are incorporated at a place such as where product is stable, unlikely to change, high demand of product, high rate of production. The advantage of automated flow lines are as follow. It minimizes the distance moved between operations. Specialization of operations can be done, especially material handling. Lesser working process, that is WIP. Lesser material handling labor cost, increased production rate. Automated machining operations. Automated machines perform a sequence of operation on different work parts. These machines are dial indexing machine, trunnion machine, transfer line. In dial indexing machine, parts are fixed on a circular table called a dial and is indexed between successive stations, whereas trunnion are having a vertical drum called trunnion on which several fixtures are mounted which hold part during different processes. Transfer machines are highly versatile machine with pallet fixtures. A typical transfer machine can accommodate over 33 workstations with buffer storage. Tools are automatically selected. Now, we will discuss automated assembly system, that is AAS. It is used to send part automatically. Automated assembly system use automated method at workstations rather than human being. Automated assembly system are sometimes help in line balancing. Line balancing problem is to arrange the individual process and assembly task at different workstations in such a fashion that the total time taken at each workstation is approximately the same. When workstation time are unequal, the slowest station determines the overall production rate. Now also, we will see the automated assembly system. The AAS classified by the type of work transfer system uses the system as follows: continuous assembly line, that is beverage bottling, synchronous line, that is press work or progressive dies, asynchronous lines, that is power and free system, stationary base part, that is aeroplane. The basic element of automated assembly lines consist of hopper, a container in which components are located at workstation. it gives a regular vibration to give the basic position to the workpiece. Part feeder removes component from hopper one at a time for delivery to assembly workhead. The next is feed track. They are either gravity driven or power driven, used to transfer component from hopper to assembly locations, maintaining parts orientation. The last one is escapement devices. It removes components from feed track at regular interval cycle time of assembly. Here we come to the topic flexible manufacturing system. Combination of NCH with transfer line led to the birth of flexibility instead of fixed, which was called as flexible manufacturing system, FMS. By development of NC machine tools in 1980s, product ever manufactured under program control. These were made to meet the requirement of design center, mass consumption. A series of automated machine tools or CNCs linked with automated material handling system and the central computer control for manufacturing of parts whose design is changed in random pattern is called as flexible manufacturing system, FMS. Now, components of FMS. The primary components of FMS can be categorized into two parts: hardware, such as CNC, conveyor or AGVs, and the second is software, such as CNC programs, robot programs, etc. In general, components of FMS are NC or CNC machine tool, material handling system, cutting tool, work holding device, computer control network, inspection station, cleaning and devouring station. Now, we will see the advantage of flexible manufacturing system, that is FMS. It decreased setup time, which is only for months. It has decreased labor cost, both direct and indirect. The system is generally designed for a variety of parts within same family. Parts can be fed randomly. Production is maximized with optimized sequence of machinery, and the reduced zero work in process, that is WIP. Now we will see automated guided wheel, that is AGV. AGV are material handling system that use independently operated self-propelled vehicle that are guided along different undergrounds pathway or a reflective point on floor surface. These are driverless train which move load along with predetermined route. These routes are checked by onboard sensors, mostly optical or ultrasonic sensor, and vehicle stop to avoid collision. The advantage of AGV over conveyor system is that they can be programmed to travel. They are flexible and also cost beneficial. Now we will discuss the topic types of AGV. AGV is of two types: wire guided AGV and pointed line guided AGV. Wire guided AGV. Their cables buried in rectangular channel under the floor guide these AGV. Small magnetic plates fixed to floor at some junction place give the signal to AGV during its motion. These junctions are usually at the sharp bends in the network of cable. And the second is pointed line guided AGV. These AGVs have two photo sensors which detect the intensity of fluorescence of ultraviolet light reflected by the guidelines painted by fluorescent dye. The advantage of AGV is that they are quickly erected in cheap and alternable easily. And their disadvantage is that they cannot support complex networks due to difficulty in managing junctions. The dye painted can be erased due to wear and tear and is to be repainted. The automated storage retrieval system, ASRS. It is combination of equipment and control which store, handle and retrieve material with its precision and speed under automation. This consists of assets that have racks to hold beams which contain either unit, load or material. They are one or more placed from where the material can be placed or taken out, known as pickup and deposit, that is P&D stations. Now, we come to the topic automated machine tools. This is a sort of programmable automation for a batch production, that is mid-volume, mid-variety, mainly used in CNCs. Numerical control is a sort of software control of machine tool by means of alphanumeric character recorded or punched on a tape or card. Numerical control technology is applicable to machine tool applications such as turning, milling, drilling, etc. The movement of tool, welding torch, pencil is controlled by the program with the reference to workpiece and paper and so on. Now, we come to the group technology topic. Group technology, also known as GT, is a manufacturing technique in which the part which have similarities in geometry, manufacturing process, functions, operations are assembled together. GT is based on a general principle that many problems are similar. And by grouping similar problems, a single solution can be found to set a problem. This results into saving up time and efforts. The similarities can be identified in one of the following two manners: similar in shape and geometry, similar in manufacturing operations. Now, we come to the topic Computer Aided Design or Drafting, CAD, CAD. Computer Aided Design is defined as the application of computer and graphics software to add or enhance the product design from computerization to documentation. Generally, CAD, yani CAD, had three components. Design, it refers to geometric modeling, analysis, this refers to finite element analysis, optimization, other number crunching engineering analysis, and the third is visualization. It refers to computer graphics, which include rendering a model, creating a pie chart, Cantor plot, shading, a model sizing animation. The next one is computer aided manufacturing. Computer aided manufacturing, CAM or say CAM, is a system of automatically producing finished product by using computer controlled production machines. Applications of CAM are computer aided process planning, that is CAPP, CAP, computer aided NC part programming, computerized machinability data system, computerized workstations, work estimating or say cost estimating, production and inventory planning, computer aided line balancing. Now we come to the point computer integrated manufacturing, that is CIM, C-I-M. CIM is just one step above than CAM, C-A-M. CIM is just an extension of CAD, CAM. CIM is coined to use the computer to design the product, plan the production, control the operation, and to business related functions. Basically, CIM is more concerned with information processing function required to support the production operations. CIM, CIM is total integration of all activities done by computer for the business of a business firm. Now, we come to our last topic, that is artificial intelligence, that is AI. Artificial intelligence is a part of computer science which deals with putting reasoning, intuitive capability, that is intelligence, into computer or robot or say machine. AI makes use of pattern machining method, speech recognition, robotics, and natural language processing, that is NLP, for making decision of event according to logical can computerization relationship. It is mostly used in bottling plant or forging workshop. It has two elements, that is knowledge base and inference base. The first one, knowledge base, it acts according to the situation predefined, and in inference base, the rule which use database in dual base conclude a situation. From this slide, our topic is complete.